Yes, so hello student. So last class I have discussed the knapsack problem using that dynamic programming approach, right? So this class I'm also going to explain the same knapsack problem but with a different example. Okay, so let me reiterate the concept of knapsack problem and the algorithm quickly, and then I'll go through another example vividly. Then finally I will see what are the items that has to be put in the knapsack to get the maximum variables from the store, and finally we will see what are the time complexity of this knapsack problem using brute force algorithm and using dynamic programming algorithm, right? Okay, so let me start with that knapsack problem again, right? So in a knapsack problem, what we do actually, we will have a list of n items, right? And let's say the items are labeled as 1, 2, 3 up to n. And let us assume the ith item is having the cost or having the worth vi and having the weight wi. Okay. So for any item I, cost is vi or value is vi and the weight is wi, right? And we will have a what? Knapsack, or we will have a bag whose capacity is, let's say, capital W. So our target is to pick a number of items from the set of items available, right? In such a way that the knapsack should be packed with maximum valuable items, right? And one more thing, after packing the items in my knapsack, the sum of weight of individual items present in my knapsack should be less than or equal to the capacity of the knapsack or the weight of the knapsack, right? So actually we are having two variants of this knapsack problem. One is called a 01 knapsack and another is called fractional knapsack. Okay, so in 01 knapsack, what we do, we either select an item and pick it and put it in the knapsack as a whole, or we do not select a item at all, right? So again I am telling you, in 01 knapsack an item will be selected as a whole and it will be packed in the knapsack, or an item will not be selected at all, right? But in fractional knapsack, a part of or a fraction of item can be selected and it can be packed in the knapsack. Okay, so now this first 01 knapsack problem, right? To solve this problem particularly, we will use a dynamic programming approach, and to solve this fractional knapsack problem we will use greedy algorithms, right? So now this lecture is all about what, how to solve this 01 knapsack problem using dynamic programming approach. So now before going into this 01 knapsack, let me take an example and let me solve that problem using both this approach, 01 knapsack and fractional knapsack. Okay, so now let us consider this scenario. In a store we are having three items, and these are the weights and cost of the items, right? Item 1 is having weight 10, let's say 10 kg, and cost is 60 rupees, right? Item 2 is having weight 20 kg and cost is 100 kg. Item 3 is having weight 30 kg and cost 120 rupees, 120, right? And we are assuming that the capacity or the load capacity of the knapsack is 50. It is what? 50. It means the knapsack can hold weights up to 50 kg, right? So okay, so now we'll see the solution using 01 knapsack. Okay, so in 01 knapsack, what I told, item will be selected as a whole or it will not be selected at all, right? So if we are having three items, then the selection can be like this: we will not select any item at all. This is one case. Second case, we will just select only one item. So by selecting one item, we are having how many possibilities? Three possibilities. Either item 1 will be selected, or 2 will be selected, or 3 will be selected. Second case, we will see two items will be selected. So again we will have three possibilities, like 1 2 2 3 and 3 1, right? And finally we'll try to select all three items. That there is only one possibility, that is 1 2 3, right? Okay, so these are all 8 possibilities by which we can select our items. So it is actually 2 power 3. 3 items means it is 2 power 3, 8 possibilities will be there. So first possibility, 0 item means no item will be selected. Next 3, only one items are selected, but in first case it is item 1 selected, item 2 selected, item 3 selected. Okay, so if item 1 is selected, what is the weight that is packed in the knapsack? 10 kg, means another 40 kg is blank or empty in the knapsack, and the cost I am putting in the knapsack is 60. Okay, so is it allowed? Yes, because 10 kg is less than 50 kg, so 10 kg can be accommodated inside that 50 kg, right? Similarly, if I am putting that item 2 alone, so I am fixing that 20 kg inside that knapsack with cost 100 kg. So is it feasible? Yes, it is feasible, because 20 kg is less than 50 kg. Similarly for item 3, 30 kg, weight is 30 kg and cost is 120, it can be also fixed inside my knapsack, right? So now I shall pick two items. So item 1 2 1 2 means total cost will be 10 plus 20 30, and 60 plus 100, it will be 160. So can it be fixed? Yes, because total weight of item 1 and 2 is 30, which is less than 50. Similarly, I can also fix 2, 3 and 1, 3. So 2, 3 fixing means what is 50 kg? Right. What is 50 kg and the cost is 220. Right. Similarly, for 3, 1, what is 40 kg? Right. Now, if I will select all 3 items, 1, 2, 3, right. So the total weight will be 60 and the total cost will be very high, that is 220. To it, but this solution or this particular selection is not permissible because the sum of weight of the items, that is 60, is greater than the available weight capacity of the knapsack, that is 50, right? So this is not a solution at all, right? So now out of these 7 solution, I have to find the best solution, and obviously at present this particular solution looks best for me, because by selecting item 2 and 3, right, we are able to get the cost 220, which is maximum. So this is the optimal solution. So this is how we are getting the solution using 0-1 knapsack problem, right? So now same solution we'll see by using fractional knapsack. Okay, so as already told you that in fractional knapsack, fraction of item can be selected and can be packed inside the knapsack, right? So in this case we have to find an extra parameter, right, to decide how those items will be added to the knapsack, right? And that parameter is called the cost per weight ratio, right? That we define the parameter as vi by wi, right? So vi by wi means the cost of ith item divided by the weight of ith item. So for first item, this ratio will be what? 6, 60 by 10, it is 100 by 25. So this 0-1, fractional knapsack says what? The item with highest value of vi by wi will be put first in the knapsack. So obviously this item 1 will be selected. So whole 10 kg I will try to put in the knapsack. Is it allowed? Yes, because the capacity of the knapsack is 50. So this 10 kg can be easily put, right? So I am putting the 10 kg, right, and the cost we are getting is 60, right? So next, you go for the next highest value of vi by wi. So it is 5, it's for item 2. So try to put the whole, right, 20, can it be placed? Yes, because earlier we have filled 10 kg, now it is 20. So 10 plus 20, 30, which is less than 50. Yes, so we can place this and the cost will be what? So now we will try to fill the last item remaining, that is item 3, and if we will try to fill the whole 30 kg of item 3 here, then there will be problem, because the total weight which I am fixing in the knapsack will be now 10 plus 20 plus 30, it is 60, which is greater than 50. So I cannot fix all these 30 kg in the knapsack, so I can just select only 20 kg to make it 50 kg. Okay. So if 30 kg cost is rupees 120, then obviously 20 kg cost will be what? Rupees 80. Okay. So I'm just selecting 20 kg of this just to ensure that my total items or total weight of the items fixed inside the knapsack is not exceeding this 50 kg, right? So the cost of 20 kg of item 3 is 80. So as a whole, I am getting the cost 240, right? Okay, so in the remark, I have clearly mentioned. So we are selecting just 20 kg out of 30 kg of item 3, which cost is 80. So now clearly you can mark one thing. When we applied that 01 knapsack, our optimal solution result was 220, but in this case, we are getting the optimal result is 240. Okay. So now this fractional knapsack problem cannot be solved using this dynamic programming approach. Okay, so we'll next few consequent lectures, we'll see how to solve this fractional knapsack using greedy approach. Okay. So this lecture all about how to solve this 01 knapsack using dynamic programming approach, right? So before applying this dynamic programming approach to 01 knapsack problem, let me apply that straightforward method, that is brute force approach. So if we are applying that brute force method like this case, okay, so three items are given, so we are trying all possibilities, right? So three items are there, we are having how many possibilities? Eight possibilities. So out of that, those eight possibilities, we are trying to find the highest cost, provided the weight must not exceed the capacity of the knapsack. So we are getting this. Okay. So similarly, if we will have n items, then we will have how many possibilities? 2 power n possibilities. So out of those 2 power n possibilities, we will have only one solution. Okay. So if we are solving this 01 knapsack problem using straightforward method or using brute force method, then the time complexity or the running time of the algorithm will be order of 2 power n, right? So order of 2 power means the time is almost in exponential. Okay. So for very large value of n, this time will be quite significant. Okay. So we shall see how this time can be reduced by using this or by applying this dynamic programming approach, right? So this is how we recursively define a parameter CIW in dynamic programming approach. Okay. So let me tell you what is this CIW. So C basically it is a cost matrix. It represents what? A cost matrix. And CIW denote what? That it denotes the cost of items up to I. CI means the cost of items up to I. For example, if I am writing C4 means cost of items up to item 4. Okay. And W represent what? The weight. Okay. So it is 5 means it is, let's say it is C4 5, means cost of items up to 4 means up to item 4 with what is the load? With the load 5 kg, right? Okay. So now this CIW cost matrix, which denotes the cost of items up to item I with the weight W. Okay, it can be defined like this. So CIW is equal to 0 when if I equal to 0 or W equal to 0. So I equal to 0 means if we are not picking up any item, means we are taking 0 cost or we are not getting any value, right? So we can make this CIW as 0 when we are selecting no item. So for I equal to 0, this will be 0, right? And similarly, if we are not picking up any quantity or if we are not picking up any weight, right? So in that case also, if this CIW will be 0 because W value is what? 0, right? This is the case one. So in the next scenario, we'll see WI is greater than W. So we want to fix or we want to calculate the cost up to item I with the weight, available weight W. But thing is that the weight of ith item WI, it is greater than W. So it cannot be fixed. Ith item cannot be fixed inside this W weight. Okay. So we'll just ignore that item. Means we will not consider up to ith item, rather we will consider up to I minus 1 ith item, right? So recursively we can write CIW is equal to CI minus 1 W if WI is greater than W. Means the weight of ith item is greater than the available weight. So we are just ignoring that ith item. So we are just bringing one item back, right? So now the third scenario will be what? WI is less than W. Means ith item can be accommodated in this W, right? And I value is greater than 0. Means there are some items like it is not zero, means item 1, item 2, item 3, like that. Okay, so now if we are or if that item I can be accommodated in this W, and the item I is having the weight what WI, right? So two things can happen. Either we can consider that item, ith item. Okay, if we are considering that item, its value is what? Vi plus, again we will apply that cost matrix recursively. So one item will be subtracted, so because item I is done already, so it will be Ci minus 1, and available weight it will not be no longer that W, it will be W minus Wi, because item I is already included, so it will be W minus Wi, right? Right, so this may be one case if we are including the ith item. Okay, right. Now another thing is that can happen that cost of ith item, it may be less than the cost of remaining item with that available weight. So we'll just take the maximum of ith item included, ith item not included, right? So here the available weight is W minus WI because it is included ith item. Okay, but in this case we are just discarding that ith item and the available weight is same W, right? So this is the heart of this 01 knapsack problem. Okay, how it can be solved using this dynamic programming approach. Okay, so clearly here I have explained everything. When there are no items or maximum weight to be carried is zero, right? Then CIW will be zero. You just go through this, right? So algorithm is same, whatever I have just told you here, right? So for W equal to 0 to W, you fix this C0. If no item are there, then the cost will be 0. If no weights are there, the cost will be again 0. Okay. So again, we are just writing the same thing, right? Just checking the conditions, right? And finally, this whole thing, the cost matrix will be returned. Okay. So which will give you idea about the cost of different items with different weights. I'd say rather the optimal cost, right? Okay, so now this is how we are getting the optimal cost of items to be selected. But let us see what are the items to be selected to get the maximum cost, right? So for this algorithm, the input will be n means the number of items, and W is the capacity of the knapsack, and C is the that cost matrix, right? So in the cost matrix, we have to just check, we have to go for nth iteration, and initially assume that knapsack, in the knapsack the item is 5, when there is no item. Okay, so as my loop will progress, items will be added to this set, knapsack item set, and we will finally see what are the items we are fixing in the knapsack to get the maximum available cost, right? So you just check the last entry of the this matrix C. Okay, so if that is not equal to the previous one, okay, I'll just check an example, it will be better. Then if they are not equal, then your knapsack item will be knapsack item union I, means you have to consider that I in the knapsack. And if they are equal, then you just remove or you just discard that particular item, right? We'll go for an example and we'll see this. Okay, so let us take an example. This problem, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 items are there with weights this and the cost like this. And here the capacity of the knapsack is given, W is equal to 5, right? Okay, so now we have to find that cost matrix, right? And always remember the dimension of cost matrix is the number of items cross the number of or the maximum weight of the knapsack, right? So weight of the knapsack is given 5, and the number of items available are 4. So you just, okay. So if you are not picking up any item, right, so you just take this 0 0 0. If you are not picking up any item, so this is this row, means item is 0, means you are not selecting anything, right? Item is 0 means you are not selecting anything. So for this entries actually represent what? cost. So if you are selecting zero item, then what are the what is the cost you are picking or fixing in the knapsack? Zero, right? Now similarly, this is what weight. So if you are taking zero weight, what is the cost you are fixing in the knapsack? Again, it is zero. Okay. So this thing you can clearly do. Already actually explained in my last class. Okay. So now next go for this one. This row serially. Let's quickly go through this. So next is what? C11, right? So C11 means selection up to item 1 is permissible with weight what? With weight 1. Okay. So you just see item 1, weight is 2. So item 1 cannot be accommodated in the given weight 1 because item 1 requires what? 2 kg. Okay, but in this case we are just assuming that item 1 with 1 kg, so it is not allowed. So as per algorithm you can see you have to just move one position back, so it will be C1 minus 1 1, right? So C01 value is 0. Okay. So similarly you just apply the algorithm. Okay, then you will fill the first row, then similarly you can fill the second row. So already I have told you in my last class, right? So finally you will be getting a cost matrix like this. Okay, so let me tell you what is the meaning of this cost matrix. Actually you randomly pick any item, any entry, right? So let's say this entry. So this entry actually denote what? C12 means item 1, up to item 1 you can pick with permissible weight 2. So what is the cost you can bring? 3. Let's say this entry. This entry means you can bring or you can select up to item 3 with available weight what? 4. And what is the cost you can bring? 7. So you can just we'll just verify. You see, up to item 3 weight is 4. We'll see. Up to item 3 weight is 4. So up to item 3 just let me check once more. Yes. Okay. So this entry denote what? The up to item 3 and weight 4. So similarly you can see up to item 3 this particular value weight is 5. And the cost you can bring is 10. So actually this is the final result, right? Okay. So what we want? We want to select from all items, means item 1 to 4 with the available weight what? Or with the available capacity of the knapsack 5. So we can select maximum cost what? 10. Right. So now from this matrix, C matrix, it is evident that we can pick maximum cost 10 from the store and which can be packed in the knapsack, but we are not getting any idea what are the items we are selecting, right? So let's apply our second algorithm, right? So you just start from the last entry and you just check with the previous. Are they equal? Yes. So they are equal means you just again come to here. Okay, means this item will not be included in the knapsack. So this item 4 is not included. So you are coming here, again you check with the previous one, 10. Are they equal? Yes. Again this item is not considered. Again you just compare this 10 with 3. Are they equal? No. They are not equal means you have to consider this. Item 2 is included. Right. And item 2 weight is 3. So remaining weight will be 2. Okay. So again you are coming here. So again this equal to 0? No. So again you are including the item 1. So you have to put which item? Item 1 and 2 in the knapsack. Right. So now let us check the time complexity of this knapsack problem, right? So as already told you, if we are applying that straightforward method or brute force method to solve this problem, the number of possibilities we have to get the solution is 2 power n. Okay, because if we are having n items, we have to go for n possible selection. Sorry, we have to go for all possible selection using n items. So it is what? 2 power n. Okay. So now, if we are applying that dynamic programming approach, then the running time of the algorithm will be order of n into w. So it's almost a polynomial time, but it is what exponential time. So obviously this one works much better than this one. Okay. So hence we are concluded that 0-1 knapsack problem can be effectively solved using this dynamic programming approach in polynomial time. Okay. So let me tell you how this n order of nw is coming up, because you see the algorithm. Right, this is the algorithm. So this will take linear time because it is running for how many times? W times. Okay. This will run for how many times? N times. Okay. So if we are considering up to this, then it will be either maximum of W or N. Right. But when you are coming to this nested loop, this will run for how many times? N into W times. So obviously, we have three. Either it will be order of W, order of N, or order of NW. So which one is maximum? Order of NW. So that is the time complexity of this algorithm. Right. Okay. So I'll post you few assignment on this knapsack problem. So you just try to solve them. So next class, I shall come with a new problem that is called LCS problem, least common sequence problem, using this concept again, dynamic programming. Okay, thank you all.